Hello, God bless you and welcome to this video. Now, I want to share with you something very important about prayers. And if you watch this video to the end and do the things that I'm about to share with you, there is going to be improvement in your prayer life and you're going to be seeing results when you pray. Now, you're going to know why we've been praying and praying and not seeing results. I just want to discuss some points with you that will help you in your prayer life. There is no mystery in praying. The mystery is how God answers the prayers or how we obtain the answers to our prayers. Right now, the disciples of Jesus were with him. They saw the miracles. They saw the prayer life of Jesus. They saw how Jesus turned things around. And they went to him. They didn't ask him, Lord, teach us how to do these miracles. Lord, teach us how to transform or to multiply food. They said, Master, teach us how to pray. That was their request, because they knew that the life of Jesus, the miracles and the things Jesus did, the healings, raising of the dead, and all of that, the boldness to speak, Jesus had something he was doing that gave him the capacity to live above circumstances. And that thing was prayers. And so they went to him and said, Master, teach us. They knew that if they prayed like Jesus, they were going to do the things that Jesus did. And the Lord began by, you know, giving them a model. He gave them a method to follow, not a prayer to recite as we do in error. He gave them a method. He said, before you pray, number one, recognize that you are a child of God. Have that confidence that you are speaking to your Father. That's why he said, our Father who art in heaven. Number two, recognize that you are citizens of heaven. Your Father is in heaven and you are here on earth. You are representing heaven. Be an ambassador of heaven. Represent the purposes of your home country here on earth. And number three, give him worship. Worship your Father. Hallowed be your name. And number four, be concerned about the things of the kingdom. First, seek ye first the kingdom. That's why after recognizing your identity as a child of God, recognizing your hometown, heaven, right? Worshiping your Father, be concerned about the manifestation of the kingdom of God here on earth. Let your kingdom come and let your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Now, look at the pattern. Look at the way Jesus taught his disciples. He was more concerned about the kingdom of God. And he kept telling them, my Father who is in heaven, my Father. That's the life that Jesus lived, and the disciples wondered what allowed him, what gave him the audacity and capacity to do the things he did. And Jesus taught them this principle. And he said to them, listen, I'm going to come back in the person of the Holy Spirit, and I'm going to live in you, so that your mouth will be the mouth of the Holy Spirit, your hands will be the hands of the Holy Spirit. Now, I want you to take note of this. The disciples, when the Holy Spirit came and they began to, you know, manifest the power of the Holy Spirit, and you know, the religious people began to persecute them, the Jews began to persecute them. And the Bible says the believers prayed and said, Lord, now watch what these people are doing. Look at what they have started doing. They are now threatening us. These were people who had power. They had to pray to God. And what did they say? They said, give us the boldness that we may declare the message. Now, I want you to take note of this. Prayer does not energize God. Prayer is about you. When you pray, it is about you. And you are the one to provoke the changes. Now, these disciples, they asked God to energize them, to give them the boldness to spread the message of the kingdom. And they said, Lord, do it by stretching your hands to heal the sick, to perform miracles. The Bible says after they prayed, the place was shaken and they went about preaching the gospel. I want you to know that the way God stretches his hand, it is through your hands. When you pray for something, you pray for someone to change, you pray for a situation, you pray for your country. If you don't act to change the situation, you will not get results. That's why we pray and do not get results, because we throw it back to God and expect God to use some other means to bring a change. I want you to know that God wants to use you. You remember Ezekiel in the island of dry bones? The Bible says the Lord asked him, man, do you think that these bones will rise again? And he said to God, you are the supreme, you know everything. And the Lord said, no, the power is right there on your lips. Declare and say to the bones. Don't throw it back to God. When you pray, God energizes you. God gives you the capacity. God gives you the power to provoke those changes. That's why you must learn to make statements of declaration. Prophetic faith declarations. You must learn to make them. Don't just pray and ask God to do this, God do that, God do that. He wants to do them, but he wants to use you to do those things. Hallelujah. He wants to use you. You have a situation in your life, in your family, in your nation, you want to change. Know that God wants you to change that situation. You may not be the one to go out and begin to do some physical things, but you are going to have to speak and declare to those things what you want them to be. You are praying to God to do them, and God is saying you should, because he has given you the energy, he has given you the power, he's given you the authority to be able to change things. Praise the Lord. So if you've never known this before, I want you to know that prayer is about you. Prayer doesn't change God. Fasting and prayers does not move God. It moves you closer to God. It makes you more attentive to the voice of God. It makes you more ready to be used by God. That's why if you don't pray, you get weak. If you don't pray, you can't change situations. Prayer energizes a man. The man who prays is the man who can change things. If you cannot change things, you cannot pray. Is there anything in your life you want to change? Pray to God, and God will give you the energy so that you can speak words. You can speak words. God said to Moses, you are the ones to stretch your hand over the sea. God could just speak to the sea, you know, just a simple word and split it into two. But the Lord said, Moses, stretch that rod. You know, it's about you. Prayer is about you. It's about you gathering the momentum. It's about you building the capacity so as to do the things God wants you to do. But then God wants you to be ready. Pray without ceasing. Hallelujah. Thank you for watching. I look forward to seeing you in the next one.